Hey everyone, good evening from Taiwan. It's another time for a vlog again by Pastor Peter here. And this time I want to share with you a story of when I had a whole bunch of people that I called the Avengers from my middle school reveal themselves and want to do a project together for one of their final grade term projects. So we were finishing up in a unit, I think it was about different countries and their biomes. And these several students, who I'll call the Avengers, have been begging me for already, I would say, half a year to come together and form their own team in order to do a final together, a final project together. They're called summatives at my International Baccalaureate School, so that they can get a better grade. So already, this was, 2 years back, for the individuals and societies a class for seventh grade. And basically the INS class is sort of like the IB version of social studies or social sciences. We talk about history, we talk about geography, we talked about science, we talk about sociology, psychology, sort of like a hodgepodge of everything put into one on how societies relate to individuals and individuals relate to societies. Anyways, out of the 25 or so students that I had in that middle school class, there was five of them who were outstanding. And you can tell every time that there was a quiz or a paper or an assignment to turn in, they were the first ones to turn it in. They're the ones that would ask the questions and find the answers for them. They were very they showed a lot of initiative for whatever subject that we were talking about, for whatever unit that we were in. And whatever assignments that they did turn in, it was of above average to excellent level quality. Now, whenever we have a final, or I guess a test, a summative at the end of each unit, most of the time it would be a group final, some sort of a presentation, or some sort of a creation that they had to do, a drawing, or maybe a model. Like this one time we were talking about the eco-friendly homes, a net zero energy based homes, and they all had to come up with a model for that. Well, this time it was a presentation about biomes and about a certain country. I think that they had either Brazil or Ecuador, I forgot which one. And so for already over half a year, these five individuals wanted to get together to do a project together because they knew that they would excel. And I would always say no, because everyone knew that these were the overachieving, outstanding students, and everyone in the class wanted at least one or two of them in their group, right? And in order so that people didn't think that I was showing favorites, I'd always randomize the groups. I would always use some kind of online randomizing generator. I remember one time I even took a 20-sided die and then rolled it 25 times to come up with the numbers for each of the students. And then once they knew that it was random, that they wouldn't complain anymore, because everyone understands that randomness is equal. Well, they kept wanting to form a group over and over again. Every time there was a final, every time there was a summative, they would come up to me and say, could we form a group together? Could we form a group together? And then I joked at them, because the Avengers was really popular back then. I guess it still is popular right now, but I joked with them. I'm like, what, you guys want to start the Avengers? And they said, yes, we want to be the Avengers for our next presentation. And so I always said no, because it's just not fair for the rest of the class. Finally, I caved in. Okay. And the reason why I caved in is because there had already been at least four different finals. And so for this next final, I said, you know what, I'll just take the blame if people thought it's unfair, and I'll go ahead and allow you to be the Avengers, okay? The Avengers will finally form, okay? And I just warned them, though, that, hey, you know, don't think it's going to be great, because just like the movie, The Avengers, sometimes it always starts with you guys fighting each other and trying to figure out how to work together. So it might not actually be good that all of the best students are together, because you guys might disagree, because all of you are overachievers. All of you are outstanding students. And they got together, and lo and behold, it was true. Whenever I would go to their group to see how their work was progressing, you would always hear some of them fighting each other and bickering with each other, how they didn't want that picture at this PowerPoint, they wanted it over there, they didn't want to use that statistic, or they didn't think that the content was right for that particular PowerPoint page. Or was it Google Slides that they used? Well, one of those things. I'll just say PowerPoint. So what was interesting was when they finally formed, I was surprised to not hear any complaints from anyone else in the class. It's about a 25 people class, five of them are outstanding, and when they're all stacked together, it's very obvious. But what's funny is that no one complained. I think maybe it's because they already had them many times in their groups, and also they all have heard them really loudly ask me over and over again if they can form a group together. So maybe that's why. Anyways, when they formed the group and when they finally got over their differences and showed me their final product as well as the presentation, it literally was the Avengers. Everything worked like clockwork. All of the graphs and the charts were well organized on their PowerPoint. Everything was sourced and done well academically. All of the content there was professional, both from the quotes that they cited about this particular biome of this South American country, and also their own opinions. It was grammatically, everything was correct. Everything looked beautifully designed in both their presentation on screen, as well as how they actually presented it, their communication skills. So in the end, after evaluating everything, for the middle school, they have a 1-8 system. So instead of an A, B, C, D, or F way of grading, they actually have what they call marking, basically a grading system of 1-8, 8 being perfect or next to perfect, and then it goes all the way down to 0, which is a complete failure. Like, they didn't even do it. They didn't turn anything, or they didn't even do any type of presentation. That would be a 0. Okay, all the way to around a 3 or 4 would be sort of like average. And so after reviewing everything, I gave them an 8, right? An 8 on all marks, because there's different like rubrics for where you're supposed to score 1-8. So I give them an 8 for everything, because they just did well in the presentation and their communication ability. They did well on the organization of their presentation. They did well in the content of their presentation, and their conclusions were on point. Now, the story doesn't end there. I mean, they're of course very happy that they got 8, but the way we do grading is that after the grade is done, a week or two later, we have something called moderation. Okay, I don't know if that's just what our school does or every IB school has to do this. But moderation is when you have someone else that's also teaching the same class or a similar class check your work and how you graded those summatives, those finals. And then you also check their work and how they graded their finals. And the best is when both of the classes, you're doing the same thing, same curriculum, but just two different classes. And that's what we were doing, okay? Me and this other lady, she actually happened to be my mentor, because this was my first year teaching an IB style class, which is very, very different than what I grew up with in America and in the AP system. And so once she saw that I gave them an 8 in all areas, okay, she was very concerned. Okay, she wasn't mad, but she was very concerned. And she basically came up to me as I was working on my desk and said, Peter, and we need to talk in our moderation, because I don't think you should have given them an 8. An 8 is reserved for either perfection or near perfection. So like 98 to 100%, that would be an 8. And I think you grade too easily. You're too soft on your grading. Now, I didn't really take offense, because I think she's right. I am pretty soft in my grading. This is my first time teaching at this school, first time teaching IB style. I'm not particularly familiar as she is in the grading. And so also, I'm a nice guy. Back then, I was much more nicer than I am now. Now I'm a lot more strict because now I know what I'm doing. And so I didn't argue with her. I said, yeah, okay, let's talk, right? And so we talked, and then I shared with her some samples from, or actually not samples, the whole thing, the whole presentation to her. And she gave me some examples from her class, and we did the moderation, right? But we didn't do it together, we did it separately. And when you do the moderation, it's all like saved on the Google Sheets for our school. And so what's interesting is I was always curious, like, okay, so she thinks that I gave a too idealistic score to them. I wonder what score she thought that I should give them. Because at the end of the moderation, you can just basically look at the Google form to see what score she would have given them if she was the teacher after reviewing all of the presentation. And I do the same thing for her in the samples that she gave me. And then for that particular Avengers group, I thought, oh man, you know what? She's probably going to give maximum 6 or 7 for each of those categories, right? Whereas I would give it an 8. And then what would happen is there might be a chance if she gave it a 6, I'd have to lower their score to like a 7, like the average of the two. And then I'd have to let them know. And then the parents might know, and then they might ask why. Okay, it rarely happens though, all right? That it really happens. And then I looked at the Google sheet one week later, and lo and behold, she gave all of their categories 8, 8, 8, 8. And then on the comment section, she basically put definitely and obviously a very strong group, right? And so I was exonerated. She didn't come and talk to me and say, hey, Peter, I'm so sorry that I criticized you for being too easy of a teacher. But she didn't have to, you know, because she could have been right, right? And so I was really happy that I scored them and graded them correctly, because she definitely is very experienced in IB teaching and grading, whereas I was just the learner and the mentoree, as she was my mentor. Anyways, that is the story of when our middle school, in my Individuals and Societies class, my social studies class that I was teaching, a group of Avengers-like students were formed, and then they truly did an Avengers-level job and got all 8s, basically straight A's, A pluses on that one project. And then after that, I never let it happen again, because now in my mind, I'm like, okay, I totally understand why we usually don't stack it like that, because it's unfair for the rest of the class. And then after that, basically they were scattered. The Avengers were broken up and scattered to the other groups where they can help the other groups instead. Anyways, that I found that to be a fun thing to reminisce about, and also talk to the other teachers at my school about, where we can get a good laugh and talk about our different teaching experiences. So hope you enjoyed that little story, and have a good day. God bless.